Kehilat Shari Torah for the Dvar Halacha for the day. Words of review and a little bit more in depth about some of the laws and customs of the high holidays of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, which will be here before we realize it. Today is Friday, August 14th, and this Shabbat, tonight and tomorrow, is actually Shabbos Mevarchim. We're going to bless the new month of Elul, which will begin next week. So that's a good reason to be in Shul, and if for some reason you can't make it to Shul, make sure that you note to yourself that this week coming up is going to be Rosh Chodesh. Check the calendar. Okay, Kitzur Shulchan Aruch writes as follows regarding the tzikias, blowing the shofar, in the repetition of the Amidah, Musaf Amidah on Rosh Hashanah, there are different customs regarding the number of sounds to be blown. What are the variants in customs? So we said a few days ago that there is a tradition, a custom, to hear Mea Kolot, 100 sounds of the shofar. So that's broken up in many different ways, usually with 30 sounds of the shofar at the beginning, in the shofar service itself, and then with a further 70 in the course of the Musaf Amidah. Now, how is that managed? Some people do it in this way. At the end of each of the major sets, sections, of the Amidah, Shofarot, Zichronot, and Malchuyot. Those are the three major sections, major themes that have a string of Torah verses connected together, and a Baracha at the end. At the end of each one of those, everybody blows the Shofar at the conclusion of each of those in the Chazan's repetition. When the cantor repeats the Amidah, after each one of those Barachas, we say, Areshes Faseinu. Talking about on Sunday this year, Shabbos, we're not blowing the shofar. We say Areshes Faseinu, and we sound the shofar at that point. Gives us 60 sounds, so now we're left with 40 that we still have to sound. So we do all of those at the end of the davening, right before the Titkabel in the Kaddish Titkabel, in the full Kaddish at the end of the Amidah. There are some people, Nusach Sfard in particular, who space it out a little bit differently. So there are 30 at the beginning of the whole shofar service. There's a bracha, there's 30 kolos, 30 different sounds, combinations of sound, returning the Torah to the Ark, starting the Amidah. In the silent Shmona Esra, there are also shofar sounds. So this is a little bit more tricky because the Baal Tokei, the one who's blowing the shofar, has to sort of guess where people are and when it would be a good time to blow the shofar. You can't tell because people aren't signaling, they're not waving flags, they're not closing their books, they're not done, they're in the middle of the Amidah. So the Baal Tokeya, the one blowing the shofar, sort of has to guess a little bit about when is the time. So there's three sets that are blown there. After the silent shofaros, Malchios, shofaros, and zichronos, yeah? And then again, at each point when those brachas are said out loud by the chazan, so we had 30 at the beginning. We had 30 in the quiet shmon, in the stillish shmon esra, in the silent shmon esra. And then we had 30 in the repetition. That's 90. That only leaves us with 10. So there's only 10 sounds to be blown right before the titkabel, the kaddish titkabel, the kaddish that concludes the chazan's repetition. Okay, that's the Nusach Sfard way to do it. In Nusach Ashkenaz, we save most of them, a little bit less than the majority are for the end. Okay, so if anyone needs clarification on that, that's a lot to remember. So let me know and I will try to make it a little bit clearer. Now, what he says here, each community should maintain its own custom. So if you go to a shul that does this or does that, that's what you should do. Regarding the tekiyas at the conclusion of prayers, there are also different customs. And the note here, the explanatory note, simply says the tekiyas are blown in order to complete mea kolos, 100 sounds. That's the point that we're getting at. After the conclusion of all tekiyas, according to local custom, the shofar should be put away. That's a hidden. That's why we put the shofar away and should not be blown anymore. We blow the number that we're supposed to, and then that's it. Even a person wishing to be the shofar blower on the second day should not practice on the first day, okay? So that's the letter of the law. The spirit of the law is, this year in particular, but every year, we're going to have people who, for any number of reasons, a host of reasons, are not able to make it to Shul, to be with us. In past years, we have been privileged and blessed and honored, and we have merited to make our way over to the hospital and to the seniors' home over at Shepherd and Shepard and Leslie there, right? Include people in the mitzvah of shofar who wouldn't otherwise had a chance. That's not going to be possible this year, as far as I understand, because of restrictions on visitors and guests at the hospitals. So please, God, the merit of things we've accomplished in the past and the things that we resolve to accomplish in the future will stand us in good stead. And perhaps Hashem will coordinate it somehow or other, that no one needs to go to the hospital on Rosh Hashanah, and everyone will be able to hear the shofar in comfort and in pleasantness and in good health, which would be the ideal. In any case, we're not gonna, I don't think everybody's going to be in shul, so we are going to have a number, at least one extra shofar blowing, which will be before Tashlich. We'll announce that time, we'll put it in the bulletin, we'll put it on your tickets probably, and we'll put it in the Nachas so everyone knows that we can gather outside. For those who don't want to come inside, we can gather outside at the York Mills and Bayview intersection there, and we'll have a shofar, a mini shofar service there, which will fulfill the obligation for those who would so desire. This afternoon, the earliest time for candlelighting is 6:54. The Zmanim are on the march. Things are getting earlier now. Autumn is on the way, as is the month of Elul. Candlelighting is 8:03 this afternoon. Wherever we are, for those who would like to daven together at the same time, 7 p.m. will be the time for Mincha and Kabbalat Shabbat. For those who are registered to come to Shul and have received an email confirmation, so we will meet in the Shul at 10 a.m. tomorrow morning, and we will hope to complete services by approximately 11:45, about 1:45 is what took us last week. Hopefully we'll make it through in just about the same time. The end of Shabbat concludes at 9:07 tomorrow evening, and everyone's invited to join us for Zoom Havdalah at approximately 9:17. Have a wonderful Shabbos. This, as we say, is Shabbos Mevarchim Elul, so there's a great amount of spiritual potential contained in this Shabbat that gives the blessing to the entire month of Elul, which is our month full of preparation for the high holidays. May they come upon us for the good. For good health, long life, and being sealed, inscribed and sealed in the Book of Life for us and the entire Jewish people. Shabbat Shalom.